Hello and welcome to Red Stapler channel. In this tutorial, we are going to show you how to create a neumorphic login form design using only CSS and HTML. Ready? Let's check it out. Neumorphic design is another UI design that has become popular these days. The main concept is to use the light source and shadow in a way to create a soft 3D effect that adds focus to your element. In our example, you will see that the login form looks like it's protruding from the background, creating 3D-like impression. To make neumorphic effect like this is actually pretty easy, using only CSS box shadow. Let's work on recreating this example together. Here's the HTML page with some basic CSS setup like font setting, flex display to center the element, and default text and background color. First, let's start with adding div for the login form body. Then set the size and padding in CSS. Border radius plays important role in neumorphic design to create a soft round corner effect. Since the login form is going to protrude from the body, I'm going to use the same background color. And here's the key part. I'm going to use box shadow to create light effect. First, let's add dark shadow at the bottom right side. Then add bright color shadow at the top left side. This will make the element look like it has the light source illuminating from the top left corner of the screen. Looks good. Now we are going to start adding content to the form. Let's add a logo div, followed by the title of the form. And subtitle if you need it. Okay, let's work on the CSS. First, set the background image for the logo div. Then set the size and 50% border radius to create a circle. And margin 0 auto to center it. Next, let's work on the box shadow. First, I'm going to add a small logo shadow. Then add 5 pixels offset with the same color as login form background. Then add the bottom right shadow and top left shadow like we did previously with the login form body. Then I'm going to add some CSS to set the font styles for the text. Next, I'm going to add the input fields, username and password. I will also add a placeholder text. Then add a sign-in button. For the CSS, I'm going to set 100% width and padding for the input fields div. Then for the input, I'm going to remove the default input styles by setting border, outline, and background to none. Then set the font size, color, and padding. Next, I'm going to add sunken effect to the input fields. First, set the margin bottom and border radius. Then add box shadow like we did previously, except that this time we'll use inset instead. And next, we will add some small icons to the input fields. I'm going to use free SVG icon. You can find the link at the video description box below. Copy the SVG code from the website and place it in front of the input fields. I will also change the fill color from white to gray. Then set the height in the CSS and add some margin. Next, let's work on the button. First, remove the default button styles by setting outline and border to none. Then set cursor to pointer, set the width and height, border radius, and font setting. And finally, set a green background color. Next, add a neumorphic effect using box shadow. Then I'm going to add a mouse hover and mouse click color changing effect. Also add a half second transition time. Finally, I'm going to add a forgot password and sign up link. For the CSS, I'm going to add some top padding and set text align to center. Then for each link, I will remove the underline by setting text decoration to none. And set the color and font size. And that's all for this tutorial. If you love this video, don't forget to like or subscribe our channel to stay tuned. Thanks for watching. See you next time. Bye.